brutally attacked by group and mass. I don't know, I've been bleeding. I'm not even in a condition to talk. I've been brutally beaten up. I was there. I've been one of my activists.
Students have been on a strike for the last 72 days on fee on fee hike and of basically an administration which runs without consulting any of its stakeholders, including the students. So to restore the statutory functioning of the university and to address the fee issue, which is known to the people. Now, as the meeting ended, there was a dialogue at the meeting between the students and the teachers. A meeting ended roughly around 6, and there was some tension on the campus. There was some talk that, you know, lots is going to happen, and there was something about unease in the air. And at 6:15, 6:20, 35, 40 of us were standing in front. 300 teachers, students were behind us, and we saw these 70 masked men approaching us. And again, as the tradition has been in JNU, we thought that we'll be able to talk to these people who are approaching us and see what their concerns are. But they didn't come up. They were about 30 to 40 meters away, and we could see their faces covered. They were carrying things in their hand, and they started pelting stones of this big size. And the stones were not 1, 2, or 5. They were in large numbers, and that led to the people started running as a result of the stone pelting. And once students started running and teachers started running, they chased. They chased us in the bushes, they chased us in the rooms, and then it went on. And of course, everything that came their way was attacked. Cars were vandalized, people were beaten up. Women who were just walking or trying to be on the side were not left. And the language was very abusive. And then it went on. And for next 1.5 hours, even when the national media had reported that JNU campus is going through this, the mayhem continued. And that is what is to be underlined, that even when the news had come out, that the violence continued on campus. And it was only after 8:30 or, you know, 9 o'clock that things declined. We don't know the situation right now. Who's inside? How many people have been injured? We have SMS messages from students saying they are inside rooms. They don't know where to go. They have injuries, but they don't want to come out. So it's really, really panic and turmoil on campus. And this administration has not come out. The administration will not come out even now to express any concern. My colleagues are injured. They are in the trauma center. There is not a word from the vice chancellor saying that his teachers and students are injured and he's concerned about them. And I dare to say that even if some of us had died, this vice chancellor would not even express his sympathies that his teachers have died. So it seems that this administration has no sensitivity, concern, or anything to do with the students and teachers and the karmacharis of this university. The rest you all understand that what is it that lets the vice chancellor go on and carry on with this violence and mayhem on this campus for the last 4 years in other ways, and now literally by the use of non-students as a way to do this.
I tried entering JNU through the east gate. That's a small gate towards east side of the campus, because the main road to the campus was barricaded. When I reached the gate, the guard, despite me telling him I was a media person, did not let me enter the campus. A few minutes later, an SUV with a BJP flag on it came near the gate, and it was allowed entry inside. When I asked the guard why was this being done, he didn't have a proper answer. So I entered the campus through the IIMC gate, And when I reached the second T-point near the Sabarmati hostel, a group of students, two, three of them on the road, told me not to go further ahead. They told that a group of 70, 80 men with batons and sticks are wandering around the campus, beating up whoever they are seeing. So I stopped my vehicle and I was there on the road waiting for these people to leave. I could see after a few minutes around 70, 80 men again with lathis and batons walking around. So once when they left, I went to meet our Newsclick reporter Ravi at T-point. By then, there was an event that was happening. I mean, an event was happening there, which was stopped by the goons. A JNU Teachers Association had called for a peace demonstration, which was organized at Sabarmati, near the Sabarmati hostel. I could see chairs broken down, banners torn, and even the cars of professors were all destroyed. Glasses were shattered, windshields broken, etc. So I tried shooting something there, but then again the group of people came and we had to disperse. Once when the group left again, we came back to Sabarmati, and then by then someone told our reporter that they had also caused ruckus inside the hostels. So we went inside the Sabarmati hostel, and in room number 156, which was a room on the first floor, there was a Kashmiri student staying and his room was dilapidated. Basically, it is somewhat an isolated room in the wing, and only this room was nitpicked and was attacked. Later, we also got to know that there was another room downstairs also that was attacked. That was the room of a Muslim student again. So it is clear that the violence is being inflicted on Muslim students, especially Kashmiris in the hostel. Once we spoke to the student, a Kashmiri student, and he told us that a group of men came and they broke open the door with the fire extinguisher that was on the wing. They threw flower pots inside, and the room is a mess actually right now. So once when we came out of the Sabarmati hostel, around 100 student activists had already gathered at Sabarmati hostel, and they were expecting a few more to come. By then, students from the Brahmaputra hostel, there was another call given to the students of Brahmaputra hostel to march to Sabarmati in solidarity with the students who are at the Sabarmati hostel. So this grew in numbers eventually over time. And after a point, there was around 500 to 600 students. And then they decided to march towards the main gate to break open the gate so that people who are in solidarity, who have come from outside, etc., can enter the campus.
Of January, the time is 8:39 p.m. I'm outside the gate of New Delhi-based Jawaharlal Nehru University, which just around the evening time saw a massive right-wing violence by ABVP, who brutally thrashed student leaders and students, including the JNUSU president Aishi Ghosh, who was hit on the head and she was severely bleeding. I'm outside now and the situation is quite tense. There are around 100 ABVP members armed with cricket bats, lathis, and they are chanting Bharat Mata Ki Jai, Jai Shri Ram, and it's a quite aggressive situation. There are around 200 police personnel, but they seems to be just a spectator here. Just now, ambulance was stopped by the ABVP protesters. They are not allowing any ambulance to go inside. One ambulance attempted to go inside, and the ABVP protesters stopped it. And they deflated the tires, abused those doctors or nurses who were inside it, and they also deflated the tires and broke the glass panels of the ambulance. The situation is quite tense. Luckily, the ambulance was able to get out of the whole hostile situation. And that's the update till 9:15. 10:45 p.m. Yogendra Yadav and 4-5 people along with him who are gathered here were brutally beaten up. Two women who were with him were brutally dragged. Their hairs were pulled. They were manhandled. They were really... during all these violence, what was happening when the women were being beaten up by the ABVP, police didn't even intervene. They didn't even bother to intervene. So, situation is better now outside. And more than 500 civil society members, students of JNU, former students of JNU have gathered here. And they have pushed back the ABVP people and formed a human chain around the gate.
Yeah.